Hey there, guys, it's Silas, and welcome to the pit. As it's now 2017 and we are 5 years in the clear of any possible apocalyptic outcomes, I think it's time I point out something that is legendarily shit. Welcome to Revelations 2012. Yes, this game is based on that Mayan apocalypse that was supposed to happen in 2012 that I was really looking forward to but never fucking came. But that didn't stop them making a video game about it. Oh, no, 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 no. In fact, they sharted this out onto Steam just in time. However, I'm going to amend the title here. Welcome to Revelations 2013. You see, this game, after its release, had to be updated. And so much of it had to be changed. It's practically a different game to what it originally was. Unfortunately, I don't have any footage of the original game because they are quite fond of denying that ever existed. However, Jesse Cox does have a full Let's Play of the original bad version on his channel, which he managed to complete, amazingly, with WoW Crendor, and I'd recommend going to see that any day, because it is absolutely stupid. But let's dive in and show you why this game is such an excrementable turd. This is your start screen. You've got a campaign, a single-player mode, which surely is the campaign, and Battleground. Don't have any idea what that is, never going to find out. But since it's there, let's do the campaign, shall we? Play online? No. Play with friends? I wouldn't rush this on my worst enemy, let alone my friends. Play on a Steam group server. Are you starting to see the problem here? They still think people are going to be playing this online. But let's try a quick match, shall we, and see exactly what happens. Fail to join games! Creating a new public game. Well, there's a fucking surprise. Right, we get to choose characters. I can be Ben, who looks like a potato. Megan, who seems to have gold glowing eyes. Kelly, who has the same weird kind of alien glowing eyes as Megan. Corey, who looks like... That doesn't even look like a face. That looks like someone just got a load of, like, tanned skin Play-Doh and just smushed it together and gone, that'll fucking do. But let's go with the most human-looking one of them all, and that's saying a lot, shall we? Okay, you look evil. Okay, we're playing as Megan for the sake of keeping things vaguely funny. Invite friends. Oh, no, 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 no. Right, let's go. How do we ready up in this game? Yep, well, I can mute myself. That's always a good start. Start the game. There we are. Sorry, that was me being a stupid derp face. Kelly, Corey, Ben, and Silas. Well, that's a winning combination if ever I've heard one. Okay. I think one of the problems I have with, like, this game, just on visuals alone, is its font. That is an appallingly awful design choice. Speaking of appallingly awful design choices, I hope you're enjoying this really long loading screen. Because there's thousands of them. Now, please note, my rig was built to handle Deus Ex Mankind Divided. This is not that level. It should be loading this in a heartbeat. What it seems to be doing is loading it in the heartbeat of a dead man. I will try and cut out loading screens in the future because I know how long these things are. I just wanted to make you all suffer as well. Come on, loading bar. Fucking finally.
Ancient Mayan prophecy. On December 21st, 2012, the gods will return during the Dark Galactic Alignment.
Yeah, that never happened, did it?
That four warriors will rise up to defeat evil and free mankind from enslavement. You have been brought here to fulfill that prophecy.
Four warriors will arise. Nope, we're just gonna steal them. Here is Budget Stargate.
I am the High Priest of Ishel, sent here to advise you. The armor you now possess has been given to you by Ishel, the Protector. It has the power to destroy gods and to capture their crystal essence.
Thank you.
The souls of your vanquished enemies to charge the crystals in your armor. You will find weapons scattered along your path that are worshipped as idols. Be careful, as these godly trinkets are protected by warriors and demons. Your primary objective is to search and obtain these crystal skulls. Collection of these
crystal skulls. Oh, we're going after Indiana Jones's loot, are we?
To advance your quest and summon the gods. Go now.
Yeah.
And fulfill your destiny.
Shoot enemy with secondary energy to create a blaze. Now, allow me to discuss what's different from the original version. First of all, none of this armor existed back then. Don't get me wrong, the awful, awful voice acting did. Are you noticing any similarities to any other games that you may know? Yep, this is pretty much Left 4 Dead with Mayans. Now, you might also be wondering why this game is still allowed on Steam when it has such a terrible, terrible reputation for being utter wank. Two words. Source engine. Yep, I'll eat that heart, thank you. Okay, it's Left 4 Dead meets the darkness. You know, that still doesn't redeem it any. Also, this gun wasn't in the original version. Now, the original weapon in the original version was, if you ask me, way better. Because it reminded me of the Tavlek gauntlet from Farscape, and I'm a massive, massive Farscape nerd. Yep, you can all die. Yep. Die in your Mayan face.
To keep out intruders, traps and challenges have been constructed.
Traps and challenges! Oh!
Pass the challenges to move ahead on your journey.
Can I just point out?
Look out for any hints along the way.
Now, all I know here is that you can avoid all these traps by crouching. Oh, look, the enemy's been alerted. This is literally Left 4 Dead with a Mayan skin. In fact, I can prove it, watch. Don't shoot teammates. Yes, friendly fire's in this too. Yep, I'll have all the ammo, thank you. Die, Mayans. I will make massive apologies to any Mayans out there watching this video. But this is how this game was created, and someone thought this was a good idea. Derpy derpy do. Oh, I'm taking damage from behind. Maybe it's one of these pricks with guns. Right, moving on. Yeah, this is the extent of the traps, by the way. You can avoid them all by crouching. Yep, just let the arrows go over my head. Traps? What traps? I see no traps. Clearly, the Mayans didn't think of anyone below the height of, say, 4 foot coming to attack them. So all we needed to avoid the apocalypse, if it did happen, was Warwick Davis, Peter Dinklage, basically dwarves. And this gun sound is so repetitive. No, you can't change it. God, this game is worse than I remember. Yeah, what they've done is they took a bad game and made it worse. At least with the Tavlek Gauntlet thing, you had kind of a cool mechanic, because as you collected different crystals, you collected different powers. Die tonight. Right, what's up on here? Can I take that? No, of course I can't. Die, 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 die. I don't know what happened there, but for some reason I froze in place. Now, you see, I'm out of ammo here. But the good news is, you're never really out of ammo. Your gun just fires slowly. Ben, you suck.
Let's get going.
Thank you, Captain Boring, for being boring. Yep, I'll have that. And that.
Now I'm feeling right. Better
now. Okay, for starters, you're playing a video game. This isn't porn. You don't need to pretend you're super into this. Oh yeah, avoid the darts by crouching. Yep, sorry, I went backwards a bit. So I was looking for fucking ammo for this gun that doesn't need ammo. Alright, let's go speak to Mr. Glowing Green God again.
You must defeat the servants of Ink. They will stop at nothing to sacrifice you to their god. Keep your distance from these warriors.
Save point's been reached. Oh good, save point with no fucking ammo. Yeah, be gone! Be gone, Evildons!
Be careful to avoid their troops.
Well, at least someone's helping me up. Now, you see, when I said that the Tablet Arm Gauntlet thing did kind of add an interesting gameplay mechanic, that gauntlet eventually uses up about four different types of ammo. This gun uses one. And when I say it uses one, what I mean is... What I mean to say is it has one type of ammo, but... Yeah. Right, Berserk increases rate of fire. Hello! A better gun! Oh, it's a shotgun. It's not a better gun. It's only a better gun at close range. But yeah, having all the different weapons tied onto different colours of the gauntlet, that was kind of cool, because you had to remember what the green one does, what the blue one does. Secondary concussion ammo. Shoot enemy with secondary to blast them. Does not say what the secondary is. Right, let's go this way. Oh no, we can't. It's a fucking gate. This thing is so linear, it is untrue. Die. Die in the face. And I can confirm that just like in Left 4 Dead, there's no area of the body that does any more damage. Oh look, I'm back to my no ammo gun. At least this has got 52 shots in it. What is the secondary fire exactly? Oh, I just pressed F. I'm dancing. Okay, that... I did not know that did that. That button serves no fucking purpose. Okay, Q is quick swap. E is interact, we know that. The secondary fire button doesn't seem to exist. I got nothing on this. Get energy ammo, okay. Oh, good. That means my other gun, which is slightly better than my shotgun, has ammo. Yoink. Stop stealing all my health, you incompetent AI.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Yeah, there we go. You're dead. This is pretty much all the game is, by the way. You shoot the vaguely racist drawings of Mayans. over and over and over again. And occasionally it throws a pig at you. Was that shotgun temporary? No, I dropped it when I... Whose genius idea was that? But I'm just going to go ahead of my team. Fuck them. Because clearly I'm the only one here with any brains to keep making progress. Yep, I'll have that. Thank you. Might as well get here before my AI does. Oh, there they are. They bought friends. Nice. Derpy derpy do.
Look out.
Oh, I'm out of ammo. Fortunately, this gun doesn't need it. Yoink. Right, which way am I supposed to be going? This way, maybe? The environments in this all seem so samey. Yoink. Don't shoot teammates! Well, don't get in the way of my bullets! You dick! I'm having the help before you do. Yeah, your AI are basically just hindrances in this game. He was an idiot. Oh, look, we've just come right back to where we were. You know, some indication of where the progress is would be nice, game. I mean, it doesn't have to be a big arrow that says progress this way, but... Really? Stunning gameplay design. Okay, so I think that's going to be where we end this. Because as I've just proven, you can completely break the world by just going over it. I don't think there's really much more to show you of this game. Because that's exactly what I'm going to be doing the entire time, just skipping everything. So I think we can now officially say that the people behind... Oh, get the laser gun. Yeah, the people behind Revelations 2012... were literally taking the piss. Yeah, it's telling me to get the laser gun. I can't because there's a fucking fence in the way. Thanks. And on that note, I'm going to end this here. So, thank you all for watching. And until our next delve into the pit, I've been Salus. Yeah, this is a thing that happened. And I will see you next time.